Happy is the man that has his quiver full of them. He shall be not ashamed, but they shall speak with enemies in the gates. Look at the word quiver there, and the word heritage. Those are two important words in that scripture. Now we're going to start with the question will be given to each person, the same questions. We're going to start with Sister Edwards first, and she's going to answer accordingly. Sister Edwards, Archie's Edwards, how long have you been a mom or a parent? How long have you been a mom or a parent? Thank you, Sister Edwards. Next question would have been, how many children do you have? But you said you had 6 children.
Yeah.
Okay. What was your most challenging time as a parent?
Well,
what was your most challenging time?
You know, in those days, I wasn't walking, and then my boyfriend, before husband, he was going and in the seawater. With seeing a net, and in those days, a lot of money wasn't storing. So, whatever God sent our way, was able to send them to school and they get something when the morning come. Even a drop of bush water, we was thankful for it. It was difficult, but as this song just sing, I am still here. Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord. Next question. Share with us your most memorable or happiest moment that you experienced as a parent. Most memorable or happiest time as a parent.
Well, my happiest moment is when I see them go to school and you know, there wasn't, you know, children who, you know, bad, you know, they was good children. So my happiest moment was seeing them being obedient. You know, I used to sweep the Barley Anglican school. And if I go down, when I come back, I know that the school is clean because Randy used to help me a lot. I'm so glad for that son because he's a really good son. You know, he will do anything to see we happy. And I'm so grateful to him.
Praise the Lord. Do you think rearing a boy child is more difficult than a girl? Sometimes we hear people saying that I can't go with this boy, this girl too difficult to go with. There's many problems with the girls or the boy. Which one do you think was more difficult to wear, boy or a girl?
With me?
Yes.
Don't know. I don't think all it's the same because at certain times, the girls, them just really, you have to really put down your foot on them, you know? But for my experience, my son, not really loving him, you know, but sometimes one of them have yeah.
Okay, your final question now. What encouragement would you leave with the young mothers here or the prospective mothers? What encouragement will you give to the young mothers here, Sister Rhodes?
Well,
it's hard time.
with their children, and don't, you know, sometimes they don't think, and we will go down upon them and, you know, be patient with them. And at times you will call them and say if they do something wrong, you will say, you know, you did something wrong today, and you mustn't do that. You must realize that we are only trying to help you in later days to come. I think you must encourage them at times, yeah.
Thank you very much, put your hands together for Sister Edwards sharing with us the experience that she had so far as a mom. Next we have Sister Duncan. Jan Duncan, your first question is, how long have you been a mom?
I've been a mom for 43 years.
Say again, Sister Duncan. Say again. How long?
43 years.
Okay. God bless you. That's a long time. And how many children do you have?
4 children.
4 children. What was the most challenging time as a parent? Sister Duncan, those persons are watching us online. I want to tell those young mothers out there and in our church, give them some advice as to how to bring up their children.
Well, young mothers out there, I'm encouraging you, please, to train your children in the way they should go. And remember, they are looking at your lifestyle. So don't say one thing and live a different life. I ask you, please, you don't have to be a Christian. Live a good life that your children can see. Love them. Encourage them. Sometimes, you know, you have children and your father is not supporting them. Don't take it out of them. Love them. Love them. And encourage them. If one turn out bad, be there for them. Don't give up on your children. Please, mothers out there, single, married, do not give up on your children. Love them and be there for them. Because God has given you.
Put your hands together for Sister Duncan, dear Duncan. Share no experience here as a mother. Now, Sister Vinita, next for you. How long have you been a mom, Sister Vinita?
Happy Mother's Day to all the lovely queens out there in church and in the diaspora. Happy Mother's Day to you all. Okay. Brother Henry, repeat for me again.
How long have you been a mom or mother? How long?
I became a mother on the 26th of May, 1983. I gave birth to my first child. So that is 40 years ago.
Okay. How many children do you have, Sister Vinita?
I am a mother of 5 children. 3 boys, 3 sons, 2 daughters.
Next question. What was your most challenging time in bringing up these 5 children? Most challenging time, the most hard time, hardest time, and so on.
The most challenging time used to be when I have nothing to give them. They cry to me and I cry to them.
Lord of mercy. Tears all the way. Tears all the way. Tears and more tears, Sister Vinita. Praise the Lord.
Honestly speaking,
okay. Next question. Share your most happiest or memorable time as a parent, mom, or mother.
Most
happiest,
happiest
or memorable
time, I believe, is right now. Because they all became men and women. And I only live with one and a grandchild. They all gone. Thank God for Jesus.
Praise the Lord, yes. Yes. Back to Sister Vinita. Sister Vinita, do you think bringing up a boy child or a girl child? And like I said before, person complain about boys, I said troublesome boys will be boys, girls, troublesome, they're bad, this, that, and they're disobedient to parents' advice. How is it contrast between boy and girl in your parenting?
Well, for me, I always love my girls. Every step I make, I have my girls. I always keep moving with them. Boys, I leave them home. They can run up and down, go see water, go pick somebody mango. Sometimes somebody come and they may complain to me. I always move with my girls.
Okay. Final question, Sister Vinita. What encouragement many youths these days making children? Youths making children, 13-year-old, 10-year-old, 12-year-old. What encouragement do you give to the young people there?
Young people, my encouragement to you.
Young mothers.
Young mothers.
Prospective mothers.
Make them that boy choice. Trans, but make them boy trans. Don't make choice. Don't make them like me. I make 83, 84, 89, 90, 91. I go out there and I make them, but I thank God still for them. No matter what the circumstances is, I thank God for them. And my encouragement to you today is settle. Get a good husband, make them plenty. The doctor say, make them fast and done.
Okay, that's it. Before you put your hands together for these ladies, the mothers, not yet. Before you put your hands together, I want to share a little piece of something with them. Now, I was speaking to a lady in Tongan Thursday.
Correct.
I said,